everyone. My name is Yap Yi, and I am the host for tonight's program. I hope everyone is fine and safe and not going out or roaming around. Always remember to wash your hands and avoid touching your face. Most importantly, stay at home. Although these JPO family broadcasts are amateurish, we are providing opportunities for people with different interests to learn not performance, but transferable life skills. We are doing this series of program because JPO think this will be able to help in uplifting the spirit of everyone in this long period of lockdown. Please help us to do the polling. And if you have any questions to ask, please type them in the Q&A below. So JPO are indeed very honored to be able to invite Mr. Fung Ka Hing as our special guest for tonight. With a beautiful tone color and great communicative power, Fung Ka Hing received good reputation no matter in the role of a trumpet performer or conductor. Fung is active in trumpet performance and is always invited to be guest soloist. He had performed in Hong Kong Sinfonietta, Taichung Philharmonic Winds Ensemble, the Hong Kong Symphonic Winds, Hong Kong Performers Winds, Neo Winds, and Hong Kong Tak Ming Philharmonic Winds. Fung has been the Yamaha artist in Hong Kong since 2013. And he was the principal trumpet in City Chamber Orchestra of Hong Kong 2015 and 2017, and in Hong Kong Sinfonietta from 2007 to 2014. He had also collaborated with Hong Kong Philharmonic Orchestra, National Symphony Orchestra in Taiwan, National Taiwan Symphony Orchestra, Macau Orchestra, and Guangzhou Symphony Orchestra. He had performed abroad in Japan, Taiwan, North America, Canada, France, Netherlands, Brazil, Argentina, and so forth. As an educator, Fung being active in conducting masterclass, workshop, and seminar, he is now the faculty member of HKAPA and Hong Kong Baptist University. Besides trumpet performance and education, Fung is also keen on conducting. He has been the associate music director at Hong Kong Symphonic Winds since 2011. In 2013 and 2017, he led the Hong Kong Symphonic Winds to compete in World Music Contest in Netherlands and received great success. So let's welcome Mr. Fung Ka Hing.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Mr. Fung. Hello. So would you like to share about the music and the video from just now?
Yes, that was from the Hong Kong Symphonic Winds, like the band I conduct. And we went to Holland for a Royal Music Contest competition. That was the own choice that we picked. It's a piece about the Alps, like the mountain. And it's tribute to the symphonic poem by Strauss, like the Alpine Symphony, like the composer, like the Italian composer, like Franco Cincerini. And he is like very... He loved the music. He loved the, like, you know, Alps, and he loved the poem by Strauss. So he actually wrote that piece tribute to Strauss. Alpine Symphony. And this is the band version of the poem of this.
Okay. Yes. So what is music to you?
To me, music, it's a very high dimensional thing. And it's to me like love. It's beyond space and time. It's very special. It's very powerful. And, you know, the music can give so much impact, big impact to even to move a person. So I think music is a very high dimensional thing.
Yes, I agree. So what is life to you?
Life, it's the way we live. You know, the whole life is a journey. The journey of we are finding ourselves, finding what we love, finding our interests, finding our passion, and the reason why we live. And it's the passion that to drive us to live with a purpose. I think life is about how we live.
Okay. Would you like to elaborate more on that?
To me, always, you know, music, it's a big part of my life. So I always put life... it's even higher level than music. So that's why I put the topic, music and life. I think without a life, music seems not quite there. If you live a wonderful and meaningful life, your music will become more meaningful and become like more vibrant.
Okay, so what are the different perspectives as a trumpet performer, conductor, and an educator?
To be honest, there's no much differences like between a trumpet performer and a conductor, like from the perspective of music itself, because we all serve music on stage. But I can share a little difference. It's because they're in different role. Okay, so as a trumpet player, normally what I do is I will try to understand the picture of the music from the leader of the moment. Like most of the time it's the conductor, the director, sometimes the concert master or whatever taking the lead line. So I would just like try to think what they want the music to be like. My part, I react to what they picture in their mind because they are leading, they are the main part. They take a big part of the music. So I just do my job to react to what they think, and this is how we do. So as a trumpet performer, so I think like this. As a conductor, it's the other way around. So I try to see it as a big picture, and I try to pull the ideas from each players. So I try to inspire people. So like they try to express what they see it, and it's my job to put things together.
It's like cooking.
It's like if you want something spicy and then somebody wants too much sugar, I was like, maybe not too much sugar.
So
I would just like, you know, as a conductor, so I just try to manage. But at the same time, I will give a direction. At the same time, I would try to match like a lot of thoughts from each players.
What about an educator?
Yeah, educator, it's something completely different, actually. In my experience, a lot of times, you have to put your artistic figure away as an educator. Because in the classroom, as an educator, as a teacher, the priority is to serve and help the class to get what they want. It's, to me, it's like nothing about myself. It's nothing about what I get from the class. Well, I get a lot from the class because from their reaction, from their questions, I learn a lot from them too. And but the thing, it's a priority is to serve them, to help them, to get what they want. So even though I, you know, conduct bands and orchestras and holding classes, a lot of the times, the music, actually, very, very small case, it's come to the first thing that what they want. So it's about, it's very different being an educator and a like artistic performer.
So what else do you do besides music?
I do a lot of stuff. I, as I told you, like music is part of my life, but my life, it's still full of other interests. So like to cook. I cook a lot, actually. Even, you know, like pandemic time, and then you just cook every day. Really happy to do that. But and also I like coffee. So I actually do a lot of hand drips myself and just enjoy
it.
It's all these things, cooking, like a coffee thing. It's I always enjoy the moments I'm doing it.
Yes, of course.
It's very satisfying to drink it and to eat it, but the journey itself, the progress, it's what I'm actually looking into. And also I watched a lot of movies, TV dramas, and we have a lot of time to do it now. It's actually, because I'm into a lot of cultural stuff, so I will look into different like languages program. For example, I watch a movie like a made in Turkey, and like Turkey TV drama or Nordic TV drama. It's actually very mind-blowing to watch some, like somewhere or somebody with completely different cultural background and how they see things, how they see what they do every day. It's quite fascinating.
Yes. Okay. So I noticed Mr. Eric Lee in this photo, and he was
Yes.
also one of our guest speaker for our interview. So we'd like to share about this event.
Yes, this is the Philharmonic Winds of Malaysia, their debut concert. I think back in 4 years ago, I think, if I remember correctly. And Mr. Eric Lee, he invited me to be the guest soloist for that concert. I'm very honored and pleasure. Had a lot of fun playing with this group, fantastic group, great musicians, amazing. And but the one thing I actually inspired the most is the spirit. It's the passion that they have. Because a lot of people in the group, some of them are professional musicians or teachers, but when they play music, I can see from like the music they make, from their eyes, from like the contact that we have through music, it's amazing. And also tribute to Mr. Eric Lee, he's just like the man behind it. He just worked a lot to make all the things happen. And it was very inspiring because I would say, because I live in Hong Kong, a lot of the musical scenes are quite well developed.
Malaysia,
it's very interesting because there is a great musicians from Malaysia, but not every place with a very strong like a curriculum or great program for music.
I can see
people like Eric or the people in the group, they are doing it. They're trying to do a lot. They believe in music. They believe in like music can help people out. Music is a great education. I can see they're trying very hard to do it. So the experience that I had here, they're very, you know, welcoming, you know, a lot of food, very great food. Great friends, make a lot of new friends, and playing music with the group is just fantastic.
Which part of Malaysia is this?
KL.
Oh, KL.
KL, where's KL?
Okay, so just now I saw a photo of a trumpet with mutes, and then there was like an umbrella there. So I'd like to know, is the umbrella also a mute, or does it do some special?
So this is the photo I pull up, like when I'm playing the show Say in the Rain. You know, it's a musical theater show. It's fun. So you can see a lot of mutes on the floor. It's my trumpet.
Yes.
And you see the top, there's a cop mute. You know, the mute, it's actually, I would say, the main function of the mutes are not trying to reduce the sound of the trumpet. It's actually giving the trumpet different effects with different mutes.
Okay.
So the cop mute, it sounds like you have the cup over your bell, so it's more mellow sound, more round sound.
Yes.
It can and see in the middle there's a wah wah mute or a hammer mute that we always call it to create a jazzy like funny tone. Use to try to put the edge of the mellow sound. It's kind of different effects. So you can you only see like a little collection of it because as a performer, we're always looking for different sounds. So we have the cup mute made of like metal, paper, wooden, a lot of material, like things, but you can see that. And that umbrella, it's not a mute.
It's an umbrella. Because
it's a souvenir from the show.
Oh, okay.
the umbrella, it's, you know, it's because they put rain on stage in the musical theater. Yeah, they rain like on stage.
Okay.
It's a very, very like big effect. And then the main role like holding umbrella and dance, tap dance.
Wow.
It's a really amazing show. If you have a chance to watch it, please do. It's amazing show. Great music as well.
Where was it?
In Hong Kong.
Oh, in Hong Kong?
I think that was 2015, long time ago actually.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Well what event was it called?
Singing in the Rain.
Oh, Singing in the Rain. Okay.
Yes.
We'll look up. Okay. So now, knowing what our Jesselton Philharmonic Orchestra is doing, do you have any advice or views regarding the activities that we are doing?
What? Sorry?
You know our orchestra, Jesselton Philharmonic Orchestra. So do you have any advice or any thoughts on regarding the activities that we are doing?
the tips, I would say for everybody actually, for your group and also for everybody, I always suggest people, or I actually try to tell my students, drive with your heart. Okay?
Okay.
Act with your wise. And enjoy the moment.
Okay.
Let me get into a little bit of that. Because heart is an interesting place. We are not talking about the like the organ heart.
Yeah.
It's the place that, you know, we can't quite locate it. People call it like spirit, soul, consciousness, or whatever you believe in, and the heart is always there. And it's your will. It's your will. Okay, it's where your will coming from. And it's full of positive energy. So if you drive with your heart, you always find something you love to do. And you always want to go for it. You have full of positive energy to go for what you want.
Yes.
And act with your wise, that means, of course, when sometimes you have like funny thinking or some funny, like, you know, things you want to do. But you have to think carefully, like many times with your wise, then because you make a decision to do it, because there is something, you know, something happened. So wise is, to me, it's experiences, knowledge, and confidence. So you make a decision based on experience, knowledge, and your confidence. So this is act with your wise. And of course, after you think of, you have the drive, you have the intention, you have the wise, you have the thinking, and then what else you need to do is enjoy the moment you're doing it, or enjoy the result. No matter it's a failure or it's a success. Of course, if it's a success, you're happy about it, and you enjoyed it, you know, just give you more energy to do it, give you more courage to do it. But if even it's a fail, like if you fail about something, but I think you know that you're thinking, you need to refine it. You always embrace your failure.
Yes.
Yeah. Embrace it, enjoy the moment, and then move on.
So for people who are stuck, like they reach to a point, they feel like the failure is too much. What advice would you give to them?
I would say a lot of panic coming from unknown.
Yes.
Yes, we don't know what happened, so we freak out sometime, and then we fear to get on stage. We want, when we play a solo, it's like nerve cracking.
Yes.
Why? Because I think that happens. It happened to me too. Because when I don't know what I'm doing, when I don't know how to like manage my instrument, then that's where the panic coming from. So you always get prepared, well prepared, knowing what you do. I see it actually, a lot of young players, they are actually very hardworking, very passionate about music, but they would do something different on stage.
Like what?
Like they practice this way, but they suddenly have like this, like interesting or good ideas, they want to put it on stage.
I suggest
you really have to think about it, or you have to really knowing your ability if you are able to make it. If not, I will stick to something that you have prepared because you know the situation.
Yes.
Sometimes I do take musical risk, actually a lot of times, but at the same time I do a lot of like basic training to myself to, you know, it's for that moment on stage if I want to take the risk, if I'm capable to do what I think. I think this is very important. And back to the question, it's when you have fear, I think you just have to stop yourself, slowing down a little bit, think about what do you want.
Yes. Okay.
A lot of time because you are lost. Because I think, you know, it's like, where am I? And then, but if you find, okay, this is where I'm going, this is what I want to do, normally you will back to right track.
Yes. So this is a message for all the attendees. If you have any questions, do type them in the Q&A below. And for YouTube, just type them in the live chat and we'll reply to your questions. So
I see it, like, Q&A, right?
Yes. So now, with your right variety of interests beside music, do you think all these help and influence the way you understand and play music?
Yes, definitely. Because if your life have so much stuff that you can enjoy and so much experience on different things, that really, really help you. Okay? I'm not, this is sad, but sometimes very true. You hear like a lot of great conductor, they are
Yes,
very good
yes.
already, but and then they got a very ill and then life and death situation,
Yes.
and they when they come back to it back on stage again, their music becomes so different because their life, it's not gonna be the same after you face some big moment in your life. So I actually enjoy my life a lot, to not to create but to embrace the moment that coming to me.
Yes.
Sometimes we spend too much time in the practice room
Yeah.
that we don't know the world what's going on.
Yes.
Yeah, and I think this is not good for life. I think we have to explore our lives, right? I can sometimes even like thinking about coffee taste when I'm playing music.
Yeah.
I put in like a my cooking concept in
Yes.
my approach to conducting or organizing something. It's always help. And then I read a lot too, actually. I'm not very patient at reading the whole book, but I research a lot of articles or words or whatever it is to read. I try to expand my thinking, or anything that can inspire me, I'm curious.
Okay. So, may I know if the mutes will alter the pitch in the trumpet?
Yes, if the it changed the whole balance of the instrument. So when we get the mute, when we like bought a new mute,
Yes,
sometimes we have to
yes.
adjust the intonation by cutting the parts of the
The
mute,
mute.
so it can, yes, because you can adjust the intonation. But if you see the French horn mutes, they even made like the part you can actually like a tuning slide, and you can adjust the
Oh,
resistance, then you can actually adjust the sound and pitch. So yes, it affects a little bit of the pitch. We always looking for a perfect mute that give you get great sound, even like a like good sound on all registers, and
yes,
also good
yes.
intonation. But you don't always get it, so you
Yes,
have
yes,
to
yes,
really
yes.
get into it.
So, like just now, we saw three mutes. Are there other mutes other than the three from the photo
There's a
just
lot
now?
of them, too many of them. It's like how
We
many knives for the chef.
oh wow. But then
Basically,
we
there is a basic direction. We have a straight mute, we have cup mute,
yes
hammer
yes
mute. There's the three basic mute that we have, but there's like so many more, and people are still like inventing, making more of them to try to get more sounds, different effects on trumpet. Yeah.
so about mutes, so like out of all the mutes, which mute do you like the most, or do you like trumpet sound just as it is?
It really depends on what I'm playing. Yeah, I can make some examples. For example, if I playing Stravinsky, like
Yes.
very edgy trumpet part, like loud and
Yes,
sharp
yes, yes.
articulations, I will use a very loud metal mute
Oh, okay.
because it really cut through. Because we make also plastic straight mute. If you put a plastic mute on playing Stravinsky loud stuff, it cannot cut through. You don't have that edge. It's always
Ah,
for the music.
yeah.
So there is like a not one particular mute that I like the most, but it depends on the music.
Oh, okay. So, which do you like more, conducting or performing on the
I would say the same. I really love any. I would say I love all kind of ways to express my music or my life. So as a conductor, I just it's like acting.
Yeah.
Sometimes you act like a main role, or sometimes you like a fighter. Sometimes
Oh,
you like a romantic boyfriend or girlfriend.
yeah.
Sometimes you're like a it's a parent, or sometimes you're like a good son, or it depends. But I like a lot. But I have played trumpet, you know, most of my career, and I'm still playing it. And now I actually spend a little bit more time on conducting. So this is, I can say, it's about how I spend my time. No priority, but just like, maybe I want to explore a little bit more about my conducting side.
So how do you adjust when switching between different instruments, as in the B flat and C, piccolo, trumpets, and others?
I would see it, they are all different instruments. First of all, because in my concept of playing the trumpet, I get a little bit on the technical side. It's, you're making a balance. When the balance happens, we make sound the trumpet. So it's the balance between our lips, the air, and the instrument itself. So it's one main part is the instrument. So if the B flat trumpet, the length is like this, C is shorter, piccolo it's even shorter,
yeah,
it's different instrument. So I just will get into make the balance right.
So like what is your advice for someone learning different trumpets?
Learn the basics, because if you manage a trumpet in a good way, I think if you know how to, you have the good ability, like understanding the trumpet itself, no matter it's a B flat or C or piccolo, you will handle the others right. You just have to spend a little time, but by experience, I think they will get there. It's like, I see a lot of students start with cornet and then they switch back to trumpet. Like later on, I saw people playing E flat clarinet first, and then move to B flat clarinet. I can see, you know, people playing violin, they start with half size,
yes,
right? Yeah,
yes.
But they can still, you know, grow. It's about learning the balance. That's
okay.
Why I don't really suggest people learn everything by memory, because if you like really fixed right there, it's very hard to change when you move on to something like different.
Yeah. So for the different trumpets, which one do you think is harder compared to the others?
Playing trumpet is very hard already. I would say playing a bad instrument, it's hard.
Bad as in the quality bad?
The quality of the instrument itself.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, there's I'm not looking for the best trumpet in the world, but
yes,
there must be certain level, it's, you know, reasonable level of the instrument, that you don't break a valve, or the instrument has to be not leaking, you know, it has to be in good shape.
So for trumpet techniques, which one do you think is the hardest?
Nothing is hardest. I think it's about understanding. If you understand them, learn them, and practice, get things done, I think it's the matter of time.
Okay.
Because I can share one story. I think for the trumpet player, or for even not trumpet player, you might know the trumpet player, Alan Vizzuti. He's a very phenomenal player. He's amazing. And there's a one masterclass, people ask them, like, how can you do such things, like, so good? Like, all the technical stuff, high, low, like, fast, so good. I mean, wow, like, flawless. And he's just like, I'm just lucky, because I learned everything right. So it's like, it's kind of like a wake-up call. It's not about how, it's about, I mean, do you want to do it? Or do you learn it in the correct way? Or do you want
to get it
done? Yeah.
Yes.
So we're always looking for shortcut, but there's no shortcut. Learn it.
Yes, practice. So could you give us some tips on how to blend well playing the trumpet in different ensembles, like playing in orchestra, in concert band, in chamber group, and playing solo?
Yeah, it's a very good question. I like that. Because it's the same thing I mentioned earlier as a like perspective of being a conductor or player. You have to be a good musician, and you have to know the music inside out before knowing your part. It's very true sometimes that because we trumpet player, like always reading on one staff, single line, we're always seeing things from single line. We think our melody is like wonderful. We can see a high notes there. And well, this must be very important because it's hard for us. But in the music content, sometimes the high notes mean nothing.
Yeah.
You're doubling with the first violin, you're doubling with piccolo, you're doubling E-flat clarinet. Your high note is just a color. I think this is very important that we know the music. And we put our I always say trumpet ego away.
Yeah,
we just have to put that trumpet ego away. We are not, I mean, yeah, we are loud and we are very bright sound, but we have lots of different colors. Yeah, so I would suggest really understand the music inside out. Play the sound that you think this is the most suitable for that moment. And the interesting thing the good thing about playing music live is it's different every single time.
Yes.
So you have to really enjoy the moment, really listening, really, in that moment, okay, oh, this is, you can see this coming. And then you place that sound, you think it fits the best with others, with the whole music content. And then you just blend it that way. And you will find a lot of joy playing, like even though it's a Mozart opera, for trumpet, you like playing overture and finale.
Yeah.
And sometimes two notes in between. But you can still find a lot of fun playing this if you know the music content.
Yeah. Well, how do you know when it's not too loud and when it's too loud or when it's too soft? Because most trumpet most of the time are loud, right?
We like to play loud. I have to admit that we still love to play loud for brass instrument. But we also love playing soft playing. We love to play soft as well because it's beautiful, right? So I would say because there must be, if you're playing solo, then it's your own call about the balance. If there's a conductor, I look at him or her.
Yes.
The conductor will definitely tell you if you are too loud. And we have to agree because as I said before, we have to see what they're thinking. What's the picture in their brain? Maybe the balance he thinks or she thinks, the sound, it's the balance is, I want to hear the oboe more than the trumpet.
Yes.
I want to hear the cello more than something else. It's up to the guy who lead the orchestra or the ensemble. So I would just watch. I would just try to find the balance all the time, the right balance. So, but it's, sometimes, that's why I also want to say it's when we practice dynamics, we play that dynamic in rehearsal, hopefully, ideally, on stage, you play the same. But we get more excited on stage, even though the conductor is, she's like, woo, like big wave, as you saw me did it in the recording.
Yes.
And then people get excited, play a little bit louder, and then you have to adjust. So dynamic, it's always relative. So I will just listen, open my ears, watch the conductor, or communicate with my colleagues. You will always find a good balance.
Okay. So this one is from Anonymous. So the person asks, I am not a musician, but I heard that there are different trumpets in different keys. Is this true? So now we said about, the B flat, the C. And then, so what is the difference between a trumpet and a cornet?
It's mainly it's the bore size or the bore shape.
Does the pitch, is the pitch different?
Same,
really
in
different?
B-flat. Most of them are in B flat, like basic one.
Do they sound the same or like one
no,
is sharper?
Because the making, like the technique behind it, like the engineer side of it, it's different. Like the trumpet, it's the tube, the bore size is straight.
Yeah. Yes.
And then they give the flare at the bell. And the cornet, it's like from small and they gradually grow from right from the beginning. It's more like a French horn. So the sound, it's very different.
So which one is more mellow?
The sound normally more mellow on the cornet. And I want to answer because he asked if a beginner student, like people should start with cornet or trumpet. It's actually a lot. This is very like frequent questions. I would say doesn't matter. It always depends on your size, like the body size. If you're big enough, you know, you can play whatever you want. People even hold a tuba or trombone, you know.
Yeah.
Trumpet is like much smaller.
Yes.
And but if it's a very little boy or girl, sometimes I have them start on plastic trumpet. Because you know, I always want to have you. I want them to have fun. If I'm holding like that weight, I can only hold for 30 seconds.
Yes.
No matter how good the sound I made for 30 seconds, I'm going to give it up. It's too heavy.
Yeah. Yes.
I'm just going to put it away.
Yes.
Yeah. So I would like, I want them to put on the face and keep playing. So light, and then there is a pocket trumpet. They make it very short, like they make it shorter. So like the balance, it's not so heavy and the belt side. And also good for beginners, if you are like very small. But as a beginner, like if you are like grown up, it doesn't really matter.
So this is for Yan Yao. Hey, Kahing, can you talk about your inspiration to conduct as well as your transition into conducting from being a trumpet player?
I think I started conducting a school band back in when I back from States, like after my study. The beginning, I'm just trying to help the students. I'm just trying to stand there and share what I know, what I learned, and what I think about music or playing ensemble. And I start conducting as a band director, band conductor. And then I find it's very interesting when I being on podium, like as a conductor. And that made me actually think completely different as a trumpet player. Because you see things from different perspective. And then, you know, I was as a trumpet player, I played loud, high notes, like really blasted out. But sometimes if I'm on the podium, I was like, this is not right.
Yeah.
I mean, not about playing loud as well, but not good for the music. When I sit back in the trumpet seat, I was like, what am I going to do? And see it as a whole picture. As I mentioned before, it's very hard for as a trumpet player, always reading single line, and then you have to read whole score. But it's a very good, I think it's a very good move that I actually doing this. And then you find it's actually being a conductor, it's so interesting that you can see different things in different times, and every time you're on stage, it's something that's gonna be different. And are you able to make it a whole, even though somebody get really excited? And it's about leadership, it's about knowledge of the music. You have to put a lot of work, and then this is very good for me, and it's something that I love to do now.
So was it hard when you transitioned from a trumpet?
I'm still doing both.
Yeah, but like, was it hard to learn conducting, or did you learn during your studies?
You know, I took basic things, like, you know, from teachers. They tell you how to beat. But being a conductor, the difficulties, it's not about beating. Never. You know, you can see great conductors, they never beat. They like, and then the music just like, boom, right?
Yes.
Of course, if you're great on technique, maybe the language you have, it's easier to understand like by the musicians. But I think it's really about understanding. It's also about, it's the dimension of who you are.
So what is more challenging, conducting, playing the trumpet, or cooking?
Well, you know, I shouldn't say it, but it's nothing difficult if you know it. I'm not saying that I know everything. I don't know. I don't know much
I
stuff.
understand.
But I actually learned that if I'm playing trumpet, how do I play in certain level? I learn. Maybe now I still not like not every single time I'm doing what I want, but after practice, day by day, I'm quite sure I will get there. It's like, you know, conducting too. Sometimes you give a bit, no sound. No one even watching you. I think it's like a lot of people, it's like, why are they not listening to me? It's like, yeah, but because it means nothing, right? So you practice, you know more inside, you know what's this for, or you know what's the salt, what's the, you know, herbs, what's the flavor for, and then you can make a great dish. I think it's all come with practice and knowledge, of course, to learn and to learn.
So, may I know how important is the different kind of trumpet mouthpieces? Because I know people who are all out getting all kinds of mouthpieces.
Me too. You know, as a brass player, we're always looking for the best mouthpiece for us, ourselves. You know, you'll never get it because you don't know it. You don't make for yourself. That's why you don't have a custom one. You know, it's like a mass product line. You just get what it fits better to you, and then you work on it. I think to choose a mouthpiece, but we do have some direction to go. It's you have to know the balance. You have to know the instrument. You have to know how it works, so you know how the instrument different can make your playing different, or what it's fitting you the best. It's not. There is nothing like this mouthpiece is better than the others. It's nothing like that. It's about each person. It depends on who play it, what instrument you play, and what is your, you know, physical like a condition. It's all different. Or where you're playing. You play in a small room or playing a big hall, different instrument, B flat, C, piccolo. You know, it's about the balance to the trumpet, to the instrument itself.
So, I'm curious to know if the breathing techniques are the same for all blowing instruments, be it wind or brass.
If you ask me, I would say just my personal opinion, yes, because it's science. We all take a breath to the lung. Lungs, right? If no one is different. If you are, tell me, I want to know. If your air is not going to the lungs, to somewhere else. I know teachers like kind of telling like you breathe into your stomach, and you know, even people say dantian, right? But the expression of dantian, it's like, can you tell me what is it? Right? It's different people have like so many like different meanings, right? So I would say I would stick with what my body gives me, right? So I breathe in to the lungs, and what the air does, it's giving the airstream to make the balance. So I take a breath, like natural, relax. Take as much as I can, and that's the idea. And then the others, I would let the body do it for me. Yeah, but I know I don't, maybe you know some other players different don't agree. But yeah, it's open to discuss. A lot of people have different opinion on breathing.
So this is from Stone Tong.
Yep.
So he said, "Hi, Fung sir. What is your thoughts on the different system of trumpet playing, as in American, English, and German? Thanks."
We try to like you know, categorize each kind of system, but for me, I would just say good or better.
Like how?
A good system, a better system, and that's all. Right? I don't think we have to, of course, when we analyze it, like when you're doing research or somehow like different people are doing in some kind of way that you're doing it this in particular way. Yes, but and then at the end of the day, you know, all the greatest player, you can't define them. They're just great at what they are. Right? So I just was thinking, This is a good way, yes, I learned. But if you say American way, it's very good at something. I learned the good things. English way, I learned the English way, the good things. I just like them. If I want to play this way, I just don't care about American or English or German or Russian or Hong Kong or Malaysia.
Yeah.
I would say good music, good sound, good articulations. That's all matters.
Okay. So for the chamber group, is the playing technique the same?
I would say the technique is the same, because you are always like standing or at the perspective of the music itself. So I'm always trying to separate the playing, like the technique,
yes,
and the music part first. When I train up myself, I would just put all the musical ideas aside. I would just have to know how I can manage the instrument well, like the tools that I'm using to produce a sound. So I know inside out from how to make a sound, what is the concept behind it, like how to like get a good sound, blah 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 blah. And then all the matters, all the techniques, all the things that I work on, it's because I want to make music. Because of the music that I want to make, that's why I have to train myself that I'm capable of delivering what I want to deliver.
So what is the most unforgettable memory that you have in your musical journey for trumpet and conducting?
Oh, there are so many, so many. You know, it's different age, different position, and different world. You have different moment, and it's all the moments that you should treasure. For example, I was like 10, 11 years old when I played for like families. I played pop song on a trumpet.
Oh, okay.
I just play the thing that I like by listening to the recording, and I, like, you know, I write it down, the tunes, I just play the tune without compliment, without like words, or just play it. And it was one of the greatest moment. And then of course, when you grow older, you play with different groups, and there's some moments when you play, you have like goosebumps.
Yes,
it's
yes,
like,
yes.
Oh, this is the moment. But then you know it. Okay, this is past tense already.
Yeah.
It's become your memory, but you enjoyed the moment a lot.
Yes.
And then we're trying to make another moment.
Yeah.
So this is, and then, but one unforgettable I can share is the Hong Kong Symphony wins like in 2015. You know, the band I grew up with, like the Hong Kong Symphony Winds and the my alma mater, Sing Bonaventure College and High School band. And we have a very long legacy, and we're a really good band, and it's full of good spirits. And the teacher, the band director, like, have a big influence on my music career and my music playing. And then also my teacher from Eastman School of Music, Professor James Thompson, my trumpet teacher, he changed my life by, you know, he really gave me all the perspective of as a trumpet player. So he really, really like big influence. And these two biggest influence in my life, in my musical career, they are meeting in Hong Kong, because I invited Professor James Thompson as a soloist with this Hong Kong Symphony Winds.
Yes.
And then I took a picture with both of them together. And wow. That was the moment I will never forget.
Okay, so now we would like to share a video of Mr. Fung Kah Hing on his trumpet. So for the attendees, for the viewers who are watching from YouTube, please do give us a like and subscribe.
No problem.
On behalf of JPO, we would like to thank you, Mr. Fung, for dedicating your time and energy into this interview, despite the pandemic that is happening right now. Okay, and also we would like to thank everyone who has attended and supported this program. You guys have been great. I hope you guys got the answers you wanted. And for those who are waiting for answers or you still have questions, please stay as Mr. Fung Kahing will answer your question through the Q&A below later. So please check for the link at our JPO Facebook page and stay tuned. And for anyone who is interested to share any of our program with your family and friends, it'll be on our Facebook page, Jesselton Philharmonic Orchestra. So now I will lead the prayer to end tonight's program. So please pray in whatever faith you believe in for the COVID-19. Dear Lord, we lift to you our concern for people who are more likely than others to become severely ill from COVID-19, the elderly and people with chronic health conditions. Protect them from harm and be their comfort in this time of uncertainty, and for many preventive isolation from loved ones. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, so that's it from us. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for Jess for having me.
Thank you, Mr. Fung.
Good to see you all. No problem. My pleasure.
Okay,
always my pleasure. And hope you all well. Stay healthy.
Yes. Stay healthy. Stay home.
Yeah. Drive from the heart. Act with your wife and enjoy the moment.
Yes. Okay. So we will end here. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Bye.